Hello everyone, welcome back. Today we're going to make this 3D cube rotating transition that you see on the screen. Start out with our cross dissolve. Right click on it. Go to convert, diffuse, and cross dissolve. Then you have this little wand, magic wand looking thing. Click on that and it'll take a diffusion. As usual, the free preset will be in the description below. Want to keep both the media ins and the media out. We'll delete the cross dissolve. Put the media in one on top. Click away right about here. Shift spacebar. And cube 3D. Let's put it in the viewer first so you can see. Okay, again, right click. Drop it on the cube. And front. Now select the cube and size it. Go in the inspector, uncheck the lock width, height, and depth. We're gonna leave the width. The height, go 1080 divided by 1920. There is 6 presets in all. I decided to make 5 more, and I will demonstrate them at the end of the video here. So stick around to the end to see how they all animate. That's what we want. With the cube selected, let's take the color off these. Starts with the front. Switch it to white. And select it, go to the next one. I make the right and left black. You don't really have to, but I just do it. And make the rest of them white. Back's already white. With the cube node selected, shift spacebar and transform 3D. Then you want 3D merge off the toolbar. Camera, render. While the render node selected, go up here under render type, change it from software to hardware. That'll render out much faster. Go ahead and hook your render in your media out, put media out in the viewer 2. Put the merge in viewer 1. Select the camera node. Go up into transform. Select use target. Go up here into translation. Z-axis, we'll move the camera back. You'll see it move back in viewer 1, and then you'll start to see the picture in viewer 2. Let's go to one viewer so you can see this better. If you hold down the control button, You can control how fast this thing moves. You want to bring it into where it just covers. Take your media 2, right click and hold and carry it over to the cube. Let go and select bottom. Now we have to add a pipe router right here. Hold on the Alt key. And select a point. Now on the outlet of the pipe router, you want to right click and hold it and drag it over to the cube and let go. And select top. Okay, we have the top and the bottom and the front. Let's select the transform node on the rotation X and we'll rotate that and check it out. Let's go back to the cube. In the back, let's change that to black. Make sure the X is set back to default. Select the transform node again. Under rotation, X value, right click. Modify with, atom curve. As you see, it's rotating too far at 180. So go to the modifiers tab up here. Under scale, change that 180 to 90. And you can always put a minus 90. Just put a minus sign in front of the 90 and it'll rotate the other way. And this will all be in the macro at the end. But for our default setting, we'll leave it at 90. We're going to speed the rotation up some, so under time scale, change that to 2. Now it'll rotate much faster. It's going to all be adjustable in the inspector later. But if you add back to 1, we'll play it and I'll show you the difference. Okay. We're gonna add these in the macro as well. I'll switch to easing. You have all kinds of settings here on the in and out. I'm just gonna demonstrate one for the sake of the tutorial. Set that back to linear, everything has their default settings. Now we'll make the macro. I'm gonna select everything I just did, leave the media ins and the media out. Excluded from this, make sure you get the pipe router included. Okay. Right click on any one of these nodes in between, go to macro, create macro, give it a name, I just call mine 3D cube test because I already have some in there. If you have whatever node you're going to animate selected, it shows everything over in the right in the inspector. In this case, you want to go to modifier. The modifier is the anim curves. I'm going to select all these, the source, curves. We're going to add the scale and time scale, but we're going to rename them. Go scale, right in rotation direction. And the time offset, go direction speed. Go for the file, save as group. Go for the fusion. Templates, edit, transitions, then save. Now we'll go to edit page and see if we can find it. Make sure you're on transitions, video transition. Start typing whatever you called it. Mine didn't show up. I'm going to shut down Resolve and restart it. Okay, I'm back. We'll see if we can find it. Mine's right here. You click on transition. You see the inspector over here to the right? If you want to make it reverse, put a minus sign in front of the 90. And that reverses it. When you receive the packet, it'll come in an SDS 3D cube transition. If it asks to overwrite, go ahead and overwrite. For some reason mine asked that, but I did not have a folder named that in my system. And it did not overwrite anything. And you get all six of these. And they all operate the same. Just click on the transition, and you'll see they all have the same settings. Let them all play through. Well, thanks for watching. See you on the next one.